Hey guys, it's Daps here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I am excited to have you join me in this tutorial. In this tutorial, I want to show you how you can clone any publicly available page and also secret pages like passworded pages, the back end of a website. Please bear it in mind that this clone is just for the design alone and not for the functionality. But again, you can include the functionality if you have or if you know your way around Figma designs. So that's it. I need to mention that before we continue. So I would advise that you check my cloning tutorials because I have done a lot of tutorials, maybe 30 or more of them around cloning website, WordPress theme, and a lot of them. In my last tutorial, I did a video that showed how you can clone any website with a Figma plugin to Figma designs, and also mentioned in that tutorial that you can convert that Figma designs into a WordPress theme. So I have a lot of tutorials in my cloning playlist to do that. Figma is just one of those tools that I have found very easy to clone website. I believe you're a UI UX designer, you want to easily redesign that website for another project. So basically, let's come down to this website here called mycbmastery.com. I have a default template here, a WordPress template here that I want to use. So let's copy this URL and let's bring it back to Figma and let's see how to clone it. Basically, so I use a plugin. If you come to plugins here, I use a plugin called HTML to design. So if you don't have that plugin, you might want to come to manage plugins and search for HTML to design and then launch that plugin. It's a freemium plugin. You can use it for free, but I think there's a cap, there's a limit to how many times you can use it monthly, maybe 10-15 times monthly for you to use it. So if you want to use it far more than that, you will need to invest in Pro. I have a Pro plan. What I will do right now is to paste now a URL here, which is my CB Mastery, and also check the viewpoint that we have. So you can see now that we have a mobile viewpoint and also a laptop viewpoint. So we can download several viewpoints so that you can have a more responsive website. And what the Pro will give you again is that you can choose your own breakpoint. You can change it. I may not want to have 1440. I want to have 1450. I can change that, but that is not available in the free. So that's one thing that is good. If you understand web design UI and you want to make your website responsive, and you want to choose how you want your website to be responsive. So we're working with just two breakpoints here. So let's close this and then let's hit the import button. That page is publicly available, so let's see what this plugin can do. Fantastic. So we can see that clone is done. So now let's close this and let me change this to zoom to fit so we can see what we have. So you can see fantastic clone, both the web view and the mobile view. How brilliant is this plugin? Fantastic stuff. So you can really edit this now, change some things here in Figma if you know your way around Figma. But right now, if you come to this website now and we want to clone a page like the about page, for example, so you can see that this page now is password protected. So to clone this page now, if I try to use, okay, now let's copy this URL and let's come back here. So this is page one here. I may want to maybe change this from page one. Let's call this home page, and then now let's try to clone the about page, which is page two. About. So what we should do is to come now back to the plugin here and come to HTML to design. So if I try to update this now to the about page now, and let's try to import this and let's see what this would do. So you can see this is done, and if I close this right now, so you can see what we have here. This is just literally cloned that page like that. This is even possible because it is not a page like the back end of a WordPress website, for example. This, you won't even have access to that page. So what do we do? If we come back right now, since I have the password to this page, so I just want to assume that, for example, maybe this is the back end of, I don't want to log into the back end of this website, but let's just assume that you want to clone a dashboard or you want to clone a secret members page that is not publicly available. You can just log into that page like I would do now to this page. So hit the enter button. So now I have this about page right now. You can see it's just demo content, nothing really serious. So now for me to be able to clone this right now, we just need to install the Chrome extension of that plugin Figma to design. I have that right now here. So you can just go to Chrome extensions. You can search for that. So here you can just type HTML to design. So you have this plugin here, HTML to design, install it into your Chrome, and then you would have this here. So if I come back right now to my about page right now, I can then launch this Chrome extension. So you can see here, I have the HTML to design now. So once I'm logged in, I can then instruct this this Chrome extension to clone that page. So you can log in into your Facebook page. So I've used this to clone my Facebook profile before. You can log into your Facebook, log into your Twitter, and just use it to clone. And it's fantastic. It does work. And the same thing here, I have the option here. I can choose my breakpoint. So I just want to leave this to a laptop view alone. And then you can choose if you want a section or you want to clone the entire full page. For the purpose of this example, let's work with a full page. So that's it. You can see this has been able to clone this page for us. And this file has been downloaded, and that's literally everything we need. So let's come back to HTML to design. So we can just literally, let's create a new page entirely. Let's call this page 3, is fine, just for example purpose. And now let's launch HTML to design. And now you can see that we have this option here to import via Chrome extension. So since we have that download here, I can just literally drag that file here. And you can see this, I can choose to import, and watch the magic happen now. Bingo, that's it. So let's close this and let's zoom this to fit. So you can see this is how literally this page is not publicly available. So you can see how super simple and easy it is for you to clone the backend. So you can literally use this to clone the backend of a WordPress, but just know that it is just the design you're cloning and not necessarily the functionalities. So that's it. That's how to use this plugin to clone the frontend, backend, a scripted, a secured page, your account page, or whatever page that is not publicly available. That's my time for this tutorial. I hope your time has been well spent. If it has, give me a thumbs up. If you have any issues, let me know in the comment section. I'll look out for them. And subscribe to see more awesome tutorials like this from me. I would see you in another video. And until then, stay safe.